Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat, and his black and white hat. Early in the morning, just as day is dawning, he picks up all the post bags in his van. Postman Pat, Postman Pat, Postman Pat, and his black and white cat. All the birds are singing, and the day is just beginning.
Morning, Ben. Got a delivery for you.
Oh.
Here you go.
Thanks, mate. From Victim X, there.
Thank you and welcome to A Current Affair. He is a convicted sex offender who has returned to haunt and taunt his victims. He's back in the same street where he committed his crimes, and there's nothing the law can do about it.
I'm not sorry for what I did. I'm not contrite. I'm not repentant.
First up, our convicted child molester Geoffrey Leonard. This man may have served time for his terrible crimes, but he's certainly not reformed, far from it. And he's still parading up and down the same street where the family of his young victims still live.
Yeah, and terrible things happened. You didn't have any sex when you were 13, did you? Did you? Did you? No, you did not. You never pulled your pull when you were 16. 13.
Stand back from me, please, sir.
No, don't you stand over me, you
shit. You're standing over me, sir.
I am standing over you, and deliberately so.
It was my first encounter with Geoffrey Leonard. He's a convicted child abuser and a proud pedophile.
What are you doing, Geoffrey?
Chasing these stupid idiots.
I only came here to ask you one question. Do you think it's fair that your victims have to watch you walk past their house every day?
Yeah, the victims. I'm not ashamed of having to say the victims seeing me pass. Yes.
Are you sorry for what you did to their children?
No.
Instead of leaving them in peace, he walks past their home every morning. A painful reminder of this evil creature who destroyed their family.
You know, to know where they live?
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
Where do they live?
Unbelievably, the law allows him to do it.
So you're taking us to the father of the boys who you abused.
Yes.
Why?
Would you like to interview?
Of course, we didn't let him go through with that offensive offer. We won't reveal anything about the victims to protect their identity.
Do you feel sorry for these people?
No. But you can go in and interview them. That's up to you.
He shouldn't even be allowed to live or even be in that vicinity because it's incredibly distressing. And you can see by the video footage that he actually took pleasure in taking A Current Affair to that house.
I am an honest man. I've got honest beliefs. I am true to myself. I'm true to everybody else. And I am true to God.
It's important to understand what Geoffrey Leonard is capable of. He lured two brothers, 16 and 13, into his home and his hands. He showered them with gifts and money and even sent them love letters which are too sick to read out to you. The same goes for their police statements. They were systematically sexually abused beyond belief.
I have not.
Mate, I'm not a 13-year-old boy, okay?
You are a shithouse.
You're not going to intimidate me, Geoffrey.
You are a shithouse.
Would you like to say sorry?
No.
You're not sorry for what you did?
I'm not sorry for what I did.
The man is clearly a problem for
Hetty Johnson and her lobby group Bravehearts campaign on behalf of victims.
It's absolutely unfair that the perpetrator of the crime, a vicious crime, a destructive crime, has all this freedom to live where he wants to live and to move around wherever he wants to move around, whilst the victims have been forced to spread out across the country to simply get away from him.
One of the victims has moved to Western Australia to get as far away as he can. Sure, Geoffrey Leonard has served a lengthy prison term, but his victims got a life sentence.
For the rest of their lives, Geoffrey, they'll be thinking about that animal who stole their innocence.
Not about the last time you had sex with anybody. That was an evil occasion, wasn't it?
There was no consent there, was there?
What are you saying, Geoffrey?
You are saying that you too are a raper. You're enjoying this, aren't you?
Do you think those young boys enjoyed it when you abused them as young boys?
Yes, they did.
Because Geoffrey Leonard was convicted before the sex offenders register was set up, he doesn't appear on it. The legislation wasn't made retrospective, so many of his neighbours have no way of finding out about his record.
We thought he was just a quiet old guy, but I think it should be, like, concerning for the... because there's a lot of kids that live around here.
But it's not just the school children who walk past his home that are in reach of Geoffrey Leonard. He's written more than a dozen books.
These books you've written, are they about molesting young boys?
They're about all sorts of things.
Are they about molesting young boys, Geoffrey?
They're about molesting young boys. They're about molesting young boys. How to do it.
And you'll never guess where you'll find one of his grubby publications, two of the most renowned libraries in Australia, the National Library in Canberra and the State Library of New South Wales.
I'm a writer. What I do is I'm an advocate.
Writer, pedophile,
yes.
Child molester,
yes.
Grub.
Grub. All right, grub. Grub.
He's clearly a very disturbed man. The fact that he has written books and they've been taken seriously is frightening.
The books and their author have a common cause. Ever since he left prison, Geoffrey Leonard has dedicated his life to overturning child sex laws, which protect the innocent.
Is 5 years old too young?
I don't believe there should be any age.
Would most Australians want their children living next door to a pedophile who is not sorry for his actions? Who thinks it's acceptable to have sex with a 5-year-old, a 10-year-old? That's what you're saying, isn't it?
Yes.
Shocking story. Geoffrey Leonard is not listed on the sex offenders register because he was convicted before the register was set up. That makes no sense at all, does it? The community obviously has every right to know where grubs like Leonard are living. In fact, watching that story, there's a good argument that he should never have been released without some sort of supervision. All right, a very different argument now. Four-wheel drives, the latest research on accident and injury rates.